right, I'm back out in Cali, or in California. It's been a long time. It's probably been 2 years since I've been to California. I usually don't come out here, but weren't too many options in Arizona, so we come out here to load. We got to load tomorrow. I took a week off. I had a great time at home. I really needed to reset. So it was nice to go home, and I did absolutely nothing. But we're at the Petro in Ontario, California. And I have to give credit to the United driver right here. I don't know if you can see his trailer and mirror right there. But as you can see, you see how tight the parking is? And he got out and he helped me back into this hole. So I really appreciate that. Told him thank you. It doesn't happen very often. Somebody will help you out, but he did a good job. I appreciate it. So tomorrow morning we got about an hour, or we have an hour. We have 57 miles over to where we have to go. Now it could take an hour to get there, or it could take 3 hours to get there, depending on traffic. Just got done cleaning the windows. We are ready to go. I looked on Google Maps and we have 49 miles to go. And Google Maps says it'll take 1 hour and 33 minutes with all the traffic. I see about 5 accidents. So we're just gonna take it easy. Supposed to be there about 9. It is 7:30 right now, so this should work out just about right when we get ready to leave. Pretty quiet night here at the truck stop. Nothing too uneventful. Alright. We're just gonna take a quick cruise around the truck stop so we can get out of here. Oh, I gotta pay. I had to pay for parking for a reserve spot. I actually reserved my spot day before yesterday when I was coming over here, and then you have to pay for parking. So, and I know that freaks people out, but otherwise I would have had to stay like 2 hours away, and my time is worth more than the $20 it cost to park, so I don't mind parking. But no, yeah, it's probably been a couple years since I've been to this petrol, this truck stop. I try not to make it a habit of coming to California, and I know you guys are probably tired of complaining about California. That's all right. I'm gonna figure out how to get out of here. I don't think I'm going that way. Let's go this way. You know, back in the heyday, this was a pretty wild place down here. But they have cleaned it up. Years ago, this was pretty wild down here. All kinds of bad activities going on in the truck stop. But they got security here now. This might take 5 minutes just to get out of the truck stop. So we got about an hour and a half to go over there. We're gonna load. It's only supposed to be about 30 feet long. We do have to tarp it. And hopefully we'll get done at a fairly decent time and try to make our way almost home. Now, we're probably not going to make it all the way home, home being Arizona, but try to get as close as we can. And then probably spend another night at home. Another third. Alright, let's see how much this is going to cost here. They let me go. Well, that was nice. I appreciate that. There's train tracks straight ahead up on that kind of elevated train tracks. Maybe if we get lucky, you guys will see a train for today. If not, you guys are going to see a lot of traffic for today. Oh. Lots of traffic. Okay, let's make our way to, we're going to Carson, California is where we're going. So it's kind of south. West a little bit of LA, like downtown LA, so it's about the best I can describe it. I've never been there, so it's new for me too. So all right, let's get going. Talk to you in a bit. We didn't do too bad. It only took 2 hours.
Take the next left onto East 208th Street. Then your destination will be on the right.
It only took 2 hours to go 49 miles, so that wasn't too bad. So this is the place we gotta go. But I don't know which way I'm supposed to go in or out or what. So
your destination is on the right.
I saw a truck parked back there. Let's see if I can figure this out. We'll just park right here. Alright, let's figure this out and do it again. Talk to you in a bit. Oh, I use a new camera. You guys let me know how you like the footage for the new camera. It's a new dash camera. So let me know how you like that. Alright, let me go get this loaded. I'll talk to you guys in a bit. Alright, we got loaded. We're sitting over here in Coachella, California at the TA truck stop, also known as Indigo, California. We made it out of LA It wasn't too bad. We got stuck in traffic for about 30 minutes or so, but for the most part, we're moving pretty good. I'm in a good mood, so don't bother me too much. We're taking our 30-minute break, and once we're done with our 30-minute break, we're going to have about 6 hours left on our clock. So we're going to try to get over to Eloy and get the oil change tonight. We'll hang out there tonight and then go home tomorrow. Stay home tomorrow, and then we'll probably take off on the 4th. So let's go outside and take a look at what we got. So we picked up a piece of equipment. It weighs about 27,000 pounds. And it's on a crate. Now, if you can imagine, this thing was in a shipping container. So they kind of stuck it in the shipping container. And then they pulled it out of the shipping container and put it on the trailer. Let's see what's going on under here. So you can see it's like on a big wooden pallet. Put some 4x4s down. And then I got chains. I got two chains on the front, two on the back. So far it's riding pretty good. It's hot out here. It's about, get out of the sun. It's about 107, I think, out here, something like that. So I got the truck running. All right, I'm gonna go get a cup of coffee, then we'll take off and talk to you guys in a bit. We didn't make it to Eloy. We got about an hour before we get down to Eloy. We're over here in Gila Bend at the little truck stop. Now, I did some filming here probably a week or so ago on my way back from Luke Air Force Base. So hopefully you guys will see that after this. I wanted to show you this though. Let's see. Can you see that? See, it says exhaust temperature. The truck is doing, I forget the word, but it's doing a regen, and it'll do it while it's going down the road. And sometimes if you stop in the middle of its cycle, it'll show you that high exhaust temperature. So usually what I do is I pump the idle up to about 1,000 RPM, and I throw the engine fan on to help get rid of some of that hot air. And don't turn it off until that goes out. But, we had a pretty good day. Like I said, I'm in a good mood. I had an excellent time at home, and I really needed to recharge while I was at home. So, I'm in a pretty good mood. We're going to stop, get the oil changed tomorrow, go to the house, spend tomorrow night at the house, and then we got a little 4th of July parade in town on the 4th, the morning of the 4th, so I might go down to that. And then take off and knock out 200 or 300 miles on the 4th, and then do the rest. Anyway, it's a pretty good day. We had a little over an hour left on our logbook, but I decided just to stay here. It's not that bad. Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching. Talk to you guys later. Bye. All right, we got unloaded pretty quickly. It only took about an hour. We're in Gila Bend. I decided to go home. Kind of the long way. It takes about 20-25 minutes further to go Gila Bend. So what we did is we ran west of Texas, west of Phoenix, and got on 85. I think this is 85. And then we're going to catch I-8. Take I-8 over to split with I-10, which is Casa Grande. But this is one of my favorite little fuel stops. Just an oddball, out of the way little fuel stop. We're parked right there. Big oversized load coming down the road, so we'll wait for him to get out of the way. But they have quite a bit of interesting things. You see the dinosaurs, and me and Teresa would stop here quite a bit. And they got a I think a Gila monster over there, that orange and black. There's the oversized load there. So all right, let's walk across the street. Try not to get run over and look at the dinosaurs. All right, like I said, this is one of my little, just oddball little places to stop. They have all kinds of ceramics and metalworks. Got some old tractors here.
Then these are metal. Metal dinosaurs. All kinds. I've videoed here once before. Got a little baby dinosaur there. And then around the store, they just have all kinds of ceramics. Pretty interesting stuff to walk around. We'll walk over here real quick. Now, it's been a little while since I've been here, and it looks like they're adding new RV fuel pumps in there, but they still have quite a bit of truck parking. See that right there? Watch out for rattlesnakes. It's that time of year. Right now it's about 100 degrees out here right now. So, but more metal artwork out here. Another rattlesnake sign. Little baby dinosaur. Hey, we'll go over here. Look at the Gila monster. Ah, and there's the Gila monster. Right there. It's pretty cool. I think Owen's metal too. Yeah, he's metal also. All right, one more thing we're gonna look at. There was an old cab over parked over here. And let's go take a look here. Here, as we're walking over to find that old cab over, we'll look at some of the ceramics real quick. They got all kinds of stuff here. Take a look. Yeah, me and Teresa would always stop here, just walk around, take a look. Some more of the metal artwork. All right, let's go see if we can find that old cab over here if he ain't left. All right, we're in luck. The old cab over still here. It's a little noisy, so we'll try to make it. Old Freightliner cab over. Now you see this a lot out here. Hay trucks hauling hay. They grow a lot of hay in this area. One thing about having livestock out here in Arizona is that you got to feed them, because you just can't throw them in the field and graze because there's nothing to eat. So they do grow a lot of hay out here. But there's an older Freightliner there. Looks good. Looks good. But all right, that's it. Let's next stop is the house. Let's head on home. So talk to you in a bit.